Hello and welcome to my Hidden Blade tutorial. As you probably noticed, this video is a little bit different than my other tutorials. That's because I bought a set of Hidden Blades off eBay and I'm going to try to modify them. And I'm gonna do this live, so yeah, should be fun. Those Hidden Blades are the ones from McFarlane. And you can get them pretty cheap off eBay. And those are the ones that you strap around your arm and there is a little push button, which you'll see later. And it will shoot out. It's a single way, so it won't go back automatically. So let's put this one to the side. And pop this one open. So in a pack is a fembrace. I can get it out. There we go. You get a fembrace, which I don't really need because I have my own. The material is actually pretty nice. It's kind of rubberish plastic. Feels better than I expected. You also get a kind of skull buckle, which you can clip on your belt. And of course you get the hidden blade. And the blade itself is kind of rubberish as well, kind of soft and can't really hurt anyone. And you can put it in. Let's get this out of the way. There we go. And then you can shoot it out by pushing this kind of button. It's kind of nice actually. Although the sound of that spring is kind of horrible. I mean, oh well. So my plan is to take this apart and then let's see if I can manage to get a string in so I can operate it with my finger. And so this button is not needed anymore. And there is also a lock on the back if you set it to off. Can't shoot out. Kind of a nice feature. I guess I keep that in. So on the bottom are a few screws, and if I take those out, I wonder what will happen. So let's get this out of the way. And I hope I'm able to do this, because maybe it's not possible somehow, and well, that would be disappointing, but it's always worth trying. I better shoot this out. There we go. This was just the leather pad, which is the same rubberish plastic as all the other parts. And I see some screws over here, so we'll just take those out. Actually, without the pad, it's kind of a nice compact unit. So I might strap it to my own fan braces without the pad. Right, screws are out, and let me zoom in really quick. Hopefully the whole assembly won't shoot out somehow. Come on. No idea what to expect. There we go. Not too bad. So looks like we have the blade and then just a very long spring and then the bottom part and the top part, of course. And there is just a kind of a pin that locks the mechanism into place. And let's see at this part. There's the mechanism. And let's figure out how it works. So it looks like the blade kind of comes in and it somehow should lock in. Ah, there we go. So this is kind of in there, and then if you push the blade in, it will, well, it should grab on. Come on. Maybe the other way around. There we go. And then it will kind of lock into place, and when you push the skull button, it will unlock and shoot out. Now I guess this pin, I guess it was in this way. I don't know. Ah yeah, it was in this way. Like now it's unlocked. And then now it's locked, so you cannot push this bar up. Now it's unlocked and you can push it up and it will shoot out. So let me figure out how to insert a string in here. Right, I figured out how I'm gonna do this. Right here is the bar that will keep the blade into place, and you can press it up. Now I will make a tiny hole in this bar and tie a string to it. And then I will make a hole in the bottom assembly, and the string can come out there. And it can go through this groove to this wall over here. And then I will make a hole in that wall, and it can come out and you can strap it to your finger. Now to make this hole, it's kind of risky to drill into this because it might break. It probably will break. So I will use a little needle and we'll heat it up and then just melt it through, and it will make a hole, I hope. So there we go. Hot. But not hot enough. And don't use your perfect needles for this because it will destroy it. Alright. Let's try the other way around. Right, let's try again. I suck at this. There we go. Now the bar sits right about here, so I will drill a pretty big hole around there. Right, I inserted a little test thread and let's push it through this hole. There we go. And insert the blade. Well, it still locks into place, that's a good sign. And let's snap this on. There we go. Alright, so now the blade is locked. And when I pull this thread. Oop. It's unlocked. So that works, and when I release it, it's locked again. And pull it. Oh, alright, so that works. Let's get rid of this annoying strap. Should have done this at the beginning of this video. Oh well. There we go. Now the hidden blade will be around your arm like this, and you want your ring finger to activate this blade, so I guess I will guide the thread out somewhere on this side, because this side will be kind of strange. So yeah, I have to drill a hole right here. Now of course my drill cannot really come into this groove, so I use the method of heating a needle again. And then punch it through. If it will work, there we go. Nice. Ah, come on, it's stuck. There we go. So now we have a hole. It will focus. Come on. So now we have a hole that's big enough to fit the thread through. Right, so next I will attach the thread, the mechanism, and this is the thread that I use for my leather work. So this is the kind of heavy duty stuff, and it's waxed, so it's kind of sticky, and wax will go out probably. So let's loop this through and just tie a nut in it. And because this is synthetic thread, it will melt if you heat it up rather than just burn. It will focus. It's having a hard time focusing. Come on. There we go. So if I heat it up just a little, it will secure itself into place. There we go. Now let's cut off some decent length. There we go. And then put it through this hole. There we go. And let's close this up. So insert the locking mechanism. And the spring. Now I wonder how this spring was in there. I mean, it was around this part. And then I guess it was just pushing against that locking bar. Or somehow. Now I know why this spring makes such an awful sound, because it's kind of loosely in here. I mean, looks like when you compress it, it kind of curls all over the way. I mean, look at this. It's just, there's no guide or something. Only those kind of rails that go in there. But, kind of crappy design. But oh well. And now we should have one hidden blade. Let's test it out first. Ooh, that wasn't supposed to happen. So looks like you have to put the screws in or else the blade will shoot out. Alright, I inserted all the screws and now let's try it again. It should work now. So here with the blade and let's pull the string. There we go. Push it back in and try again. There we go. And the lock still works because if I put it in this locking position, it won't pull out or shoot out. So yeah, now we can loop the thread through this hole. And you can attach this string to your ring finger. Now you can just do it like this, but I will make a ring for it. Now here I have a little piece of stripped copper wire. And if I wrap it around this glue stick, and then just bend it inwards a bit, and then snip it off. Now you should have a pretty perfect ring. It goes around your hand. Now let's secure the open ends by bending them against each other. And then I use my soldering iron. To join the ends together. There we go. Now let it cool down. And after it's cooled down, you have a nice ring. Now find out how long your string should be so that the hidden blade will somewhere be around here. And then the string must reach over here. So we'll trim it off just a little bit longer. And then tie it to the ring. And just like before, I will use a little bit of heat to secure it in place. And there it is. So now we have one hidden blade that can be activated by your ring finger. Just like that. Do it again. There we go. Now I didn't take out the skull button, so it can both be operated by this button and ring. You can take this button out if you want, but I want to leave it into place. Now the first hidden blade was a success, so now I'm going to modify the second one as well for my other arm. Alright, the hidden blades are pretty much done. As you can see, I made the second one. And make sure you do the second one mirrored. So here the thread is coming out of the right side. And here the thread is coming out to the left side. And I decided to put the kind of plastic pads back on. So it will be like this. And then I can cut some slots into this pad right here and here. And I can push the belt from my fembrace through it and secure it to that. And I might also want to trim off those brackets on the side, because I don't really need them anymore. But maybe it's not needed. Maybe I can just attach it to the fembrace without removing those brackets. Right here I have my fembrace just to dry out. So here we have a pad. Wanted to secure it right here, so there should be a slot right here, and on the opposite side, and maybe here, but let me find out later. So now we'll use my punching pliers and set it to the biggest hole possible, and then I will try to punch your holes. I'm not sure if it will work in plastic. Oh, works quite well. So there we go, and now we should be able to get this belt through and out on the other side. There we go. Now let me find out if I need to punch some holes for the other belt as well, because maybe the belt can go right underneath the hidden blade like this. But I have to screw the pad under to see. Or not really screw, but just hold it on there. So once it's screwed in place, there should be some good space underneath that. So this belt is going like this, and this one can just go underneath, I guess. Maybe not. It's gonna be tight, this is gonna be annoying, so I guess I will just make another slot on this side as well. And there we go. Well, the plastic pad is the wrong side right now, but whatever, fits through. So now let me screw the hidden blade back on. And now it looks like I don't have to trim off those brackets, because this piece of plastic is flexible enough to bend it like this and then insert your belt, and it will be underneath those brackets, so that will be fine. Let's try it out. And that's the hidden blade attached to the fembrace. I can still close the fembrace, like I always did, like this. And that's it. Let me find the ring, there it is. And now you can stick your arm in, which is kind of hard because
fabric is close right now. There we go. And attach it to your finger. And it should work. And it's on. Come on. Come on. What's going on here? Right, let's start again. There we go. Alright, it turned out that this pad presses too hard against the hidden blade, so the thread was stuck in between. So I made a little groove with my Dremel, and then the thread can go through this groove as kind of guide. And if I screw it on right now, it should be alright. And now we can fire it using this string. There we go. Nice. So now let me modify the other one. So there it is, a pair of modified hidden blades that can be activated by a ring finger. And I even managed to attach them to my own fan braces.